Hello guys, so good morning everybody. So I hope you are all able to hear my voice. So I'm just starting the class. Today is the first class. Guys, today I just want to let you know a few important topics in the Tableau. So first introduction of the Tableau. So I will repeat the various products that are available in Tableau and the benefits of various products after 2 to 3 classes, and we will see the architecture of the Tableau desktop as well as Tableau server. Today I just want to discuss with the terminology. So Tableau got its own terminology, so we will see what we call the features in the Tableau and as well as how we can extract the data, a simple data set of Excel sheet, how we can extract onto the Tableau, and how the Tableau is going to be classified the data by automatically, you know, so dimensions into dimensions and measures. So we will see all this stuff today. And guys, here 8.3 version is the stable version, and 9.0 is the latest. It just got released in May, and present 9.0.2 is running. So Tableau started with version 4.0, and they gradually they've been releasing, you know, various versions, 4.0 to the 6 and 7 and 8 and 9.0.2, and among the all these versions, 8.3 is the stable version. Most of the companies are using 8.3, but in this class, in this course, I will teach you parallelly both 8.3 and 9.0, and even the 7 and 8 and 9 differences. Because if you want to keep some sort of experience, or if you want to, if you keep 3 years experience, you must know 7 to 9 versions and their differentials and various features, distinct different features. So let's see. Guys, whatever the book right now you are seeing, it just, when you click on the Tableau icon, you will able to see this. This is 9.0. There are few differences in even in terms of, you know, so the terminology and the menus and the features comparing to 9.0 and 8.3. This is a 9.0. Here you can see the different home page. When it opens, you can see here open files, already open files here, open workbooks. You can access them straight away by clicking on the icons. And right side, you can see the various data sources. One is TF file. You can access here the files, Excel, text file, MS Access, statistical file, other files. And second is TF server. Tableau 9.0 supports more than 50 plus data sources. You can connect to the more than 50 plus data sources from the Tableau. These are the saved data sources. You may often using these data sources, so you need not to connect often to the any 2A file or 2A server. You can just click here so that it navigates to the with the data workbook. And right side you can find the, some videos and introduction videos, all the stuff here. This is home page of Tableau 9.0, and let us see guys 8.3 how it works. This is 8.3. As soon as you click on the Tableau icon, so Tableau icon 8.3, you will see this kind of home page. Here you can see the workbooks that you already opened and using this 8.3. So right side you can see the, you can connect to the latest data, so any data sources, or here you can see the saved data sources. And say if you click on connect to the data in 8.3, as I told, the terminology is different. Here we got in a file on a server, but in 9.0 we call it 2A file and 2A server, just slight difference. So the action and everything is similar. The only the name they got changed, the words in a file on a server in 8.3. In 9.0, 2A file, 2A server. That is the only difference. And now, I just want to let you know that how we can extract the file. First, let us start with Microsoft Excel, so that it makes us very simple. You know, we can see that how can connect. So I'm just, so let's work with 8.3. I'm just connecting Excel sheet using to in a file. The moment when you click on it, it will show you pop up where you can connect to the various data sources. Here you got a sample data. So sorry, I just clicked on Microsoft Excel access. So we need Microsoft Excel sheet. So I have a sample data called Superstore subset here. Just click on it, select open. We have a two type of connections here. We will see those connections and differences in coming classes. Right now I'm straight away extracting the data from the Excel sheet by just clicking on open button. But here you can see the open with the legacy connections, show previous versions. Forget about the show previous versions. Open with the legacy connection is different from open. So we will see what is this open with legacy connections. So this is an interview question. If you attend interview calls, you can expect this question over there, and even the certification also. Okay, just click on open. So it's extracting the data. So here we got three tables, and you can see even the data by clicking this table icon. So we have here around 9,426 rows, and we have city, customer name, various data columns. So we will discuss about this data in coming classes. In this session, we just need to understand the different features and terminology of Tableau 8.3 and 9.0. So that is the context of this class. So here we can see the data. Here orders and returns users are three different Excel sheets. Each sheet will be treated as a single table in the Tableau. So that's how it understands the Excel data. And then here we have an area. This is called joins area. This area is called joins area. Whatever drag sheets here you are able to see is called joins area. When you drag and drop orders onto this area, it will load the information in the worksheet area. Here it is worksheet area. Here it is a joins area. You can see these orders and everything here, and at the top you can see the live and extract connections and filters also. Various filters here we got. These filters called data source level filters. You will get an interview question asking about how many types filters we have in a Tableau. So you need to remember this also. This is called data source filter, and even we can discuss live and extract connections in coming class. So here we got an orders. So if you want to join multiple tables here in this area, you just drag and drop returns also and users also. So here you can define the schema, whichever schema that you want. Say example, it allows you to join in four ways: inner, left, right, and full outer join. And you can map whatever field you want from the table 1 and table 2. So here it allows you to define your schema. But the only drawback Tableau's got is schema is not that flexible comparing with either Oracle Cloud BI or MicroStrategy or other database services. So here first we will see the joins and letter. So first we got here orders. That's fine. Just click and go to worksheet. You can see here the dimensions and measures. That's absolutely fine. So we got here the dimensions and the measures. Tableau understands the Excel sheet data and it's automatically classified data into the dimensions and measures. That is a question mark. How Tableau can understand the data and classify it into the dimensions and measures without our this thing, intervention. So this is 8.5. Rajitji, can you mute on? Hello? Hello? So, when we extract the data, so we got data onto the data window. This entire panel is called data window. We can minimize and we can maximize this data window. Is called data window, so it's absolutely fine. Now let's go to the 9.0. How it works, what are the various different, you know, things we have here. And guys, here when you double click on the data source, it navigates you to the this area where you got joins area, and the you can see the Tableau format data here. And you might know about ETL tools, extract, transform, load. So, and you might know the roles. If you don't know, so we can discuss about data various concepts after third or fourth class. And we will see the how ETL exactly works. So we have various terminologies when you work with ETL, various ETL tools and data warehousing concepts. You might see the cubes, hierarchies, MDX, multi-dimensional expressions, and etc., etc. Here, as soon as you got the data onto the your Tableau, Tableau allows you to do two roles. So one is extract and transform. It never allows you to load the data. Once you're done with, you know, transforming data one form to another form, it never allows you to the reload data into the any data source. It's one-way process. You can extract the data and you can analyze the data and you can share the dashboards and scorecards. That's it, reports. It never allows you to reload data into the again data source. So now here, if you see here, say row ID you got, if you want to change row ID name, you can rename it. Or if you want to hide this column, you can hide this column. So say example, here I got a customer name. I don't want customer name. Guys, remember, this is 8.3. You got only two features. One is rename and hide. Rename and hide. And 9.3, we have multiple features. That's the reason. Please note here, you got rename and hide. That's it. In 8.3, you got two features that either you can rename or you can hide the entire column. Say example, I want to rename customer name as a CNAME. So I got changed it to CNAME. Got it. And here we got various data types. We can use various data types also. When you click on the add symbol, all the measures, all the numbers will all the members always assigned with add symbol, and all the dimensions will assign with ABC symbol string. Okay, measures always with hash, and all the dimensions always with ABC. And there is a difference even for this light blue color and light green color, the green color and blue color. We will see that changes also. These are very important. These minor things are very important because if you want to write the certification, these are the questions, one mark questions you will find in the certification examination. And I will arrange you 50 predefined questions and along with answers out of 60. So here you got number of data types, number whole, date and time, date, string, default and geographical role, area code and city. So various latitude and latitude, we got various things here. It's absolutely fine. So if you want to change the data type of any of your columns appearing here, you can change. So that is the use. Here I'm just lifting two things. One is connection, live and extend. Second is filters. We will discuss these two things in coming classes. So this is about this join areas and this tableau format. And coming to the 9.0, let's see how it works. So I'm not taking any file here. Just click on this icon. So it navigates to the work area. This is where we can work. We work, we design the sheets, dashboards, single views and everything. So as soon as you click on here, you can see the connect data. Here you can connect to the various data sources, or else you can press the button, cylinder plus button. Here it shows up all the available data sources. And here you can see the empty dimensions panel and measures panel. And the additional thing you can see here, the analytics. Here we got all the analytics shortcut features. These are shortcuts. Even this same analytics we got in 8.3 also. But you can't see this here. This analytics you will find here in the analysis. So we will find those things also here. And in 9.0, so we have empty dimensions and measures. So let's now discuss about this data window. And before that, let us get the Excel sheet data here. So here I got same like 8.3. When I drag and drop data by row, here I can see the various features. It's loading the data, and if you are not able to see it, go to worksheet option here. You just need to click the sheet one so that you can see the latest data. Here you got go to worksheet. Here you don't have a go to worksheet button. In 8.3, you have here go to worksheet button. In 9.3, directly you need to click on sheet 1 so that it navigates you to the sheet. Here we got the same columns as we have. Here we got live and extract and data source filter. Now the features are different here. If you click here, in the 8.3 we got only rename and hide. Here we got aliases, split, custom split and pivot table. This is very important. Select multiple fields and pivot. This pivot helps you to say, example, you are uploading some Excel data and it's not formatted well to analyze the data. So you can straight away analyze the data and you can select the multiple columns. So maybe the columns are here as a rows. So you can select the multiple columns and you can click on pivot. It will change the rows as a columns. It can segregate the data. And custom split, you can split the data here under this column into the multiple things. So we can see all these features, but just remember here, we have a distinct difference between this data and here. Here we got rename and hide. Let's cancel this. And I just wanted to load another data here. Click on Excel. And I just want to super substore. So take the orders. So earlier you did not find that data does not look right. Tableau data interpreter might be able to help you. This data interpreter is an interview question. So you'll get an interview question from your interviewer asking about what is Tableau data interpreter. So we will see also, we'll see and the use of data interpreter also. So what will happen if I turn on the interpreter and what will happen if turn off the interpreter? So these are the things, the difference between 9.0 and 8.3 as of now. And let's go into the subject. So here we got dimensions and measures in the data window. So guys, This is called data connection panel, this is called dimension, this is called measures. But what you are seeing here, three panels, here we have a maximum five panels. One is parameters and parameters and sets. If I connect any saved data source, means I did already OLAP, I mean online analytical processing. I made this data ready to analyze. So that's the reason you can see the two more panel here is called sets and parameters. Last you can see the parameters. So this is superstore. I made this superstore ready to analyze. So you can find here the hierarchies and the folder structure and perfect, and each and every data you can see the calculated fields, other stuff also. So because I made this data ready to analyze, I will let you know that how we can make the data like this. As of now, our context is just understand the various terminologies here. The maximum panels you can see in the data window that can be minimized and maximized, or one is data connection, dimensions, measures, sets and parameters. So when you take the raw data, so you can see the only three panels, data connection and dimensions and measures. Now guys, so fine, I got prepared already in a nice PPT for this startup class. So you need not to note anything. So I prepared here what we call dimensions and rows and everything. So I will share this document with you guys. Now, let us first see how Tableau can understand the data and classify it into the dimensions and measures. That's very important that we need to understand. And we have a flexibility. We can drag and drop any dimension under the measure and any measure under the dimensions as well. So it's, we have that flexibility because it allows you to drag and drop the things and various dimensions and dimension panel under the measure panel. It depends upon your analyzation requirement. So all the dimensions are string data types. All the dimensions are string data type. And second thing is IDs. IDs means Tableau understand that all the sequential IDs consider as a dimension, and date data types will be considered as a dimension. And the fourth is geo data type. All the postal codes, cities, states, countries will be considered as a dimension. Four things. Remember here. First thing is all the string data types, or else we can call it categorical information. This will be considered as a dimension. And the second thing is all the sequential IDs will be considered as a dimension. And third thing is date data types. And the fourth thing is geo data types. These four things consider as a dimensions by default in Tableau. And you can change this. Dimension can be changed as a measure. Measure can be changed as a dimension. Depends upon your analyzation requirement. And what are called measures? Measures are pure numbers that happen through transactions. Pure numbers. All are numbers, discount and product based margin, profit, quantity order, new sales, shipping, unit price. And there are few additional things that are not existed in our database or table. Those are measure names. So we will see about the measure names in second class. And here it's latitude, longitude and number of records and measure values. You will get an interview question and as well as certification question about number of records. See, there is a difference between the actual other measures and this number of records. It's by default generated by the Tableau, but number of records is the only value that is a calculated field you will get from the Tableau by default. That you need to remember here. And so now we got the classification that dimensions coming from the string data type, date data type, geo data type and sequential IDs. Measures are the pure numbers. So this is how it classified the data and put the data into the dimensions and measures. So now we're done with data window. So this entire called data window. Now coming to the, this is called column shelves. This is called row shelves. So now I'm taking product category onto the row shelf. So department onto the category onto the row shelves. So here we got 17 categories under the department. See here, in the right side extreme, you can see how many columns, rows you have by one column. One column is category and the rows you got around 17. And I just wanted to see the amount of sale that I received across the various categories. And let's turn on the labels. So you can see the amount that you received across the various categories. So this is amount that I received. This is called horizontal bar. So I don't like this horizontal bar. I just want to swap this. These are the columns and rows. Here you got a swap icon. Just swap. You can see the vertical bars. So these columns and rows act like a X and Y axis, but these are flexible, not static. They won't stick. You can swap these columns and rows, depends upon your requirement. Got it. So in the terminology wise, we call these column shelves and row shelves, and the fields that we dropped on the column shelf or row shelves called pills, P-I-L-L-S, pills. So because it looks like a pill, the end curves and everything, it looks like a pill. And see here, the color also, this is in a certification question. When you drag and drop any measure, it looks in light green color. And every dimension, it looks in a light blue color. Got it. So you need to remember these things. So now we're done with column shelf and row shelf. What is pages? So we have one separate class to understand pages, but in terms of definition, pages helps us to create animated views and filters. Filters helps us to create various filters from existing dimensions and measures. Say example, here I got the sale that happened from various, say example, minimum $8,000 to the maximum around 1.1 million. So I just want to apply filter to this. So you just drag and drop sales onto the filter card. We call it filter card. And don't select any of these aggregate functions. We will see these aggregate functions in coming classes. Just click on the next, click on OK, and go to here. Click on show key filter. So that you can see the filter starting with $1 to $100,000. And you can slide this so that forward, you can see that data is filtering left side. This is how you can create the filters from the existing dimensions and the measures. So we will see how we can create the more dynamic filters using parameters in coming classes. This is just introduction and terminology that you need to understand here. We call it filter cards. Filter cards helps you to create the various filters from the existing dimensions and measures. And coming to the marks, this is the most important thing in the Tableau, because using this we can play and you can create wonderful, beautiful visual analytics in the Tableau. So marks card got various marks. The bar chart can be converted into the line chart, and line chart can be area, and area can be the square and circle, shape, text, field map, pie, grand bar, polygon. So we can connect all this stuff using this marks. On the marks card, you will find the marks, and we have a various components here. Actually, we have here 8 components, but 5 are visible. One is very dynamic. It depends upon your view. This component is going to be visible. Here we got colors, size, labels, detail, tooltip, and you can see angle and path. One more is shape. The moment when you select the various, say example here, right now we don't have an angle here. If I select here, pi, you can see the angle here. And if I select here, line, you can see path here. And you can select here, shape, you can see the shape here. So this is an interview question they will ask. When will you see the component on marks called path? So when you are working on the line chart, you will see the component called path. When you are working on pi, you will see the component called angle on the marks card. When you are working with shape, you can see the component called shape on the marks card. So this is very dynamic, and by default visible is color, size, labels, detail and tooltip. We will see each and every feature of this component in coming classes. Just understand here the meaning, colors, how it helps us, and everything we can discuss in coming classes. So hope we are done with the marks. And whatever we are seeing here, I just drag and drop department and the colors. We got here some stuff, so with various colors. And this is called legends. We call them legends. And you will get number of interview questions and how we can play dynamically with these legends. So we will discuss those things also. But just remember here, this is called legends. Now, this entire sheet is called work area or sheet. Here we got sheet one. If you want to know something, in each sheet you will have a single view. This is called single view, and you can have a multiple views. So here we got sales, and here got profit of various departments and of their respective categories, profit and sales. We can see here both. So we can have a multiple views, but it considers a single view. If you want to combine two views in a single this thing, that is called dual axis. We'll discuss in coming class. And if you want to understand about this entire view, just right click here and click on summary. So you'll get the entire summary here. Some profit and some sales, what happened, what is some average, minimum, maximum, median, everything you'll get here. So this area is called sheet area. Got it. So this is what we done with the sheet and other options here. And the most important thing here is show me card. Show me card, it's got around 24 default predefined views. So when you keep mouse over, it will tell you that text tables. If you want text table, you need one or more dimensions, one or more measures. This is called show me card. You can cancel show me card and you can click on it. You can drag and drop it wherever you want it. And see here, right now each and every view got disabled here. So I just want to see enable views. When you select the sales, you can see this histogram and horizontal bar got enabled. And if I select the department as well by holding the control key, here I can see the stack bar and pie chart, box plots and bubble charts. These charts got enabled. So it will suggest you appropriate chart depends upon the selected data. So that's the reason it's very easy to for us to analyze the data. The moment when you select the dimensions and measures, it will show you the appropriate data views, how we can view those data using this predefined views in the show me card. So that is a show me card. Show me card holds the predefined views that helps you to select the appropriate view. And coming to the file. In this file, you can have a new, open, close. It's similar menu of file, a save as. There is a difference between save, save as, and export package workbook. Save. When you click on save, you will see the TWB. In the Tableau, we got around 8 extensions. We will discuss each and every extension in the coming class. So as of now here, let's understand two different extensions. We got TWB and TWBX. TWB, see here, when you click on save, you will see TWB extension. Save or save as, whichever button you press, you will see the TWB. The difference between the TWB and TWBX, TWB holds the only the logic. So I got here horizontal bar dividing with the sales and profit across department categories. This is the logic that it holds. Logic or the calculator fields. This is a calculator field that I created, gross profit. So it holds all the logics and formula. It never holds the data. So when you click on the TWBA file using Tableau Reader, it will ask you to navigate the data file. So if you don't have a data file, you can't visualize the data. So that is difference. When you click on package workbook, so you can see the TWBX. This package workbook carries entire data along with the logic. So say example, if you are analyzing 10 GB data, the TWBX file size also is going to be 10 GB. Hope you got the point. So that's the reason Tableau desktop is not secured. We can easily break and see the data is there in the Tableau workbook. That's why, you know, Tableau introduced Tableau server. It's more secure. The moment when we are done creating the dashboards or views, we will publish them using server menu onto the Tableau server. Okay, that is different story. So hope you got the difference between save as and export package view. These are the very common things, and here this is repository location. So we will see the folder structure once, you know, when we are discussing about hierarchy and architecture. We will see the folder structure where you can find the log files, where you can see the all these data saved files and etc. And coming to the data, in the data, it's help you to connect a new data source. You can paste the data, a Tableau data server. You can connect to the Tableau data server, edit relationship. This is, you saw the data joins, right? Joins helps you to join various tables, and edit relationship. This helps you to join two different data sources. That is new concept in the Tableau. That is called technically data blending. So you will get number of interview questions on the data blending as well. And replace data source is kind of boon. Once the logic and everything is done, if you have another data, you just, and the fields names means column names and everything is similar to the superstore subset, you can simply replace that data with this view. So that entire view is going to be look with a different data. So I will show you that also. So this worksheet, this menu helps us to create new worksheet, copy, export, clear. The important thing in this worksheet is actions. So it helps us to navigate from one sheet to the another worksheet and create various actions. So next is dashboard. Under dashboard, again, the important thing is actions. We have actions at two levels. One is worksheet level and dashboard level and story. So guys, here when you click on this icon, you can create a view. When you click on this icon, this is a new dashboard. Dashboard is nothing but collection of views, and here we have a various components: horizontal, vertical, text, image, web page, and blank. Here you got a one certification question, that what is the component that automatically enabled, what is the object that automatically enabled in dashboard? The object is called tiled. This is by default enabled. This style option is by default enabled. So you will get these kind of certification questions. Even you will get one more certification question. When I keep mouse over here, here we got sort icons. Least, highest, highest, least. When you keep mouse over, you will see the by default highest to least sort icon. So even this is also a certification question. So Tableau, they design interview questions even at minor level. So now, what is a story? Story is nothing but a collection of sheets and dashboards. But here you got a story button. In the 8.3, you won't see the story button. You got only sheet and dashboard. Story you have to create from the menu itself. You don't have any icon for the story. So that is story. And coming to the analysis. This menu helps you to find all analytical stuff here. From the advanced to the, you know, so creating calculated fields and parameters and the sets, etc., etc. And the maps, background maps. If you want to have a background maps, we can get your background images, geocoding, because Tableau gives you by default only US geocodings. And rest of the things you have to upload from here, you will get the geocodes and everything from the Google. You can have to upload here and you can start analyzing the data on the geocodes. And the formatting actions, you can format the data that you are able to see here. And the server, this is a separate menu. Once we done with in a real time creating dashboards, views and etc., we will publish them using publish workbook. And here we can create user level filters. This is different from this. We will discuss about this in a filter class. This filter enable to access users the specific content based on the roles and responsibilities. and the window. Here you can uncheck and check the various toolbars that are available and visible to you, and help document. The very important thing in the help document is manage key products. Here you can enter the key product and you can activate your Tableau. So, and the finally, this helps you to connect the various data sources. This helps to add the worksheet. This duplicate the worksheet same. Say I have there, if you click on it, you can see one more duplicate worksheet. You can play with this worksheet now. You can cancel this worksheet. And this is. So, in we saw the connections, we have two types. Connection live and extract. When it is live, so do you want to have auto update worksheet, or if you don't like, you can uncheck, or you can pause this, or you can play this. Fine, this is just latest updates that we can get, and we can refresh the data. These are, we can swap the rows and columns. These are the sort icons, list, highest, highest list. This is labels that you can able to display here by clicking it, and these are the various options of the sheet, and this is so width and height of the sheet, and you can pin it. This icon is disabling workbook highlighting and all the fields, dates and times, category, department. We will use according to our requirement all these features. And the final one, this is important. Once you are done with designing worksheet, you need to check it how it looks to the end user. So end user is going to be see the entire dashboard like this. Right side you can see all this stuff, and left side you can see the legends. So that is shortcut button is F7 and escape is to exit from the presentation mode. So these are the various features and terminologies there in the Tableau. Guys, I'm done with class. Now it's questions time. You can raise the questions if you have any.
Parallelly work with two different versions and compare it on the way, or we are going to learn one version and then at the end we do the comparison?
Yeah, since I know I got an experience in two versions, I'll let you know that. Say example, I'm teaching something like KPIs, a sales KPI example. So here it's important that I need to let you know the difference between KPIs in 8.3 and 9.0. We are about to discuss so many problems here. Few problems are similar in both 8.3 and 9.0. Few problems is going to be changed in 9.0 and 8.3. So those problems we can work in parallel in 9.0 and 8.3. So that you'll get a knowledge on both versions.
So but what is the primary version that we will be running, 9.0 or 8.3?
8.3, because it's a stable version. Most
okay.
companies have used
okay. 8.3. So we'll learn 8.3, but throughout the class we will just compare it to 9.0 wherever required.
Yes, absolutely.
Okay.
Yes. So as I said, you can download this version from Tableau software. So initially I can say download Tableau public. I will let you know how to download Tableau desktop and install. First download Tableau public. I will share the data sources that I have and few links where you can get the various data sources. So here you got a Tableau public. Just get it download. So it's as similar as Tableau desktop. It never allow you to connect the data sources like this to a server. It allows you to connect the Excel sheet, other stuff, other file stuff.
The Tableau public does not require any
license.
Purchase.
Yes.
Okay.
It's absolutely free.
Okay. And all the other functions will be available.
Everything is similar.
Except
only
for the connection.
Yes. Only option is to a file. You don't see the on a server. And one more thing, once you're done with the designing all these dashboards and everything, here we got server. Right? Here Tableau Public, save to Tableau Public. This is the button you need to click. You will see the disabling. You will see save and save as is disabled. Export package workbook and everything. So you can't save in your local host. Once you're done with designing, you have to save this file in Tableau Public. From there, you will get the TWB and TWBX files. Did you get the point?
Not really, Matthew. So,
see,
since you're saying that.
Now I'm done with designing a sheet right here. This is Tableau Desktop. So I can save this file by clicking Save and Save As. So when I click this file, it is going to be stored in my local system, right? Yeah, it is storing in my system itself, in a laptop. But for Tableau Public, the save as and the export package workbook got disabled. It never allow you to save the file. You can save the file under this server menu. You will find Tableau Public where you can see the save to Tableau Public. The same workbook can be saved in Tableau Public. Tableau Public is nothing but it's a website. Tableau's website. So you need to have your email ID, password, enter, so that they will give you 1 GB space. There you can deploy all your views, workbooks. From there, you can download TWB, TWBX files.
Okay.
New extensions. Got it. Yeah.
TWB and TWBX, we need a Tableau reader,
yes.
Right?
Yeah, it's free. Any client can download Tableau reader from the products. So he can install the Tableau reader. It's a kind of PDF reader. That's it. So the moment when you install, all the Tableau extension file will be appear in Tableau icon.
Like to give us some exercises which we should do every day in order to recapture whatever you have spent.
After third class I will start giving you exercises. Just right now you got only terminology, right? You don't know how to make the data first, you know, ready to visualize and how to create calculated fields and parameter, all this stuff. After third class itself, you know, I will start giving you various exercises. You will also get the hands on.
We are discussing so many features, it is like difficult to retain everything.
Yeah, definitely. I will share with you the exercise.